Time for our out of this world lead. We're gonna need a song for this moment.
Upon a time I was falling in love, but now I'm only falling apart. There's nothing I can do, a total eclipse of the heart.
Ah, yes, Bonnie Tyler's Total Eclipse of the Heart. You're welcome for that earworm. It's all but certain to climb the charts once again now that we're all about to take in a total eclipse of the sun next week. Only 5 days to go until you see people wearing glasses like these as they look up toward the sky to safely watch the solar eclipse. But the viewing path of this highly anticipated spectacle could be ruined by severe thunderstorms. And now people are scrambling to change their plans and locations to ensure they get to see this rare phenomenon. And CNN's Kristen Fisher is here. She is so excited about the eclipse, and she's trying to convince me that I should be too. Why are people making such a big deal out of this?
Jake, I think this is one of those rare moments where people can kind of all come together and marvel at the power of nature when it's not doing something destructive, right? Like, this isn't a tornado or a tsunami. This is our solar system turning day into night in a matter of seconds, so dark that the stars actually come out, nocturnal animals come out. That is what you get if you're in that all-important path of totality. And so one of the other really cool things about this particular total solar eclipse is the length, the duration of that moment of totality. Back in 2017, it was only about 2.5 minutes. Now, for this eclipse, it's gonna be almost double that amount of time. So people can really kind of enjoy it. And then you've also got the fact that this eclipse is coinciding with a really powerful period of solar activity. So the sun itself is actually much more active than it was back in 2017. And that means during the moment of totality, you can actually see those coronal mass ejections, those solar flares, all that stuff coming off the sun. And so it looks cooler too.
And you're excited about the raccoons that will be coming out in the middle of the day.
Yeah.
During the moment of totality. But what about the thunderstorms that are gonna be in the path of the eclipse for some places? Which viewing areas will not be compromised according to the weather report?
So as of now, we're still a few days out, of course, so have to put that caveat in, but Southern Missouri, Indianapolis, and Buffalo, New York, upstate New York, New England, they're looking pretty good, but Texas, Arkansas, those are some areas. I mean, that's like, those people have spent so much time and money and invested so many resources into going there, and they're looking pretty dicey right now. I'm reevaluating my plans.
So apparently there are, first of all, I can't see a word. I mean, I can't see anything in this, but there are
people, means those work.
Apparently there are counterfeit glasses going around. These are real ones, mm-hmm. I can tell because I'm basically blind. How can people tell if they're real or not, the glasses?
It's tough to tell. You'd love to see something that says made in the United States with a barcode. That's the good stuff, so to speak.
How dangerous is it? Remember we saw Donald Trump when he was president?
That's what you should not do.
Squinting.
You don't want to do that.
But that can really actually hurt you, right?
You can go blind. And that's something that's really important that you need to tell kids. If you want to take your kids out to look up, you need to prepare them because you can take your glasses off if you are in the path of totality during those 4 minutes where the moon totally blocks the sun. Any other time you need to wear these glasses, and a good trick to be able to tell if your glasses are real or not is to hold them up in a room, and if you can see any light whatsoever,
they're not real.
They're not real. They're not strong enough to protect your eyes. But
so do you know that when I was a kid, mm-hmm. and I mean like a kid in the 70s, and if you want, they didn't have these fancy glasses. You couldn't get, you know what you had to do?
Pinhole.
You had to poke a hole through a piece of paper, and then you'd look at the eclipse on a piece of paper, which is honestly really lame. But that's how we did it back in olden days.
That's what you had to do. And if you look at the Navajo Indians, they would make their children go inside to prevent them from ever looking up at the sun. So that's how they prevented it. But Jake, one final thing to sell you. If you miss this one, you won't get to see it for 20 years if you live in the United States. So this is your chance to see a total solar eclipse for the next 20 years.
All right, I'm ready to go. Kristen Fisher, thank you so much. And you should join CNN on Monday for Eclipse Across America. We'll be on the air with special coverage starting at 1 p.m. Eastern on CNN, streaming on Max.